I really think it starts with the younger grades. So with my kindergarten and first grade class, for example, no matter what they make, at the end of class, we all sit down together. Every student has a chance to show their classmates and show me what they worked on. And I give them an art participation sticker for sharing what they did. And we might discuss things like, oh, do you think this student used crayon? Do you think they used marker? How did they go about this? Or even just giving them a chance to tell their story through their art and feel proud of whatever it is. In my backboard, I will hang up any artwork that they produce because I want them to just see it, be proud of it, be proud to share what they've did, even if it's not good. So I think that is really just starting to get them into that mindset of it doesn't have to be perfect. The point of art class is that you're making something, that you're producing, you're experimenting, and that you have something to show for it at the end of the class. I can only hope that that starting off throughout the years gives them the license to be more creative, to produce whatever they want in art class, to take those risks and take those chances and know that it doesn't have to be perfect. Because from an early age, I was telling them, you know, just produce something and that's what you get credit for in art class, the effort. With the fourth, fifth, and sixth grade here in this scenario, that's when I start to do a little bit more teacher-led projects because I want to give them that extra boost of confidence that they need, saying, hey, this is the project that we're all working on. There really is no perfect way to do it, but it's going to be your interpretation of it. Whereas with the younger grades, so say second and third, I've started doing more free art days with them because they don't really need me to assign the project. They're just really eager to dive into it and to experiment and try it out.